Well, here you have it, the finished product, minus some cosmetic touches. I have added in a multimeter, because I'm going to still put a handle on the top to make it easier to carry. I do not have the screwed in yet, but a multimeter, so you can always read what the voltage is on the battery, even while it's connected. Of course, we have the timer. I used a 1 to 12 hour timer. Obviously, you can always unplug it too. Use a simple light switch as an on-off switch as well. I prefer the timer that way. I have a problem where I set something and I forget to shut it off. And you can boil out a battery with this system, as there is no automation or overcharging safety features whatsoever. So, we got on this side, just to show you a little bit more of the wiring. Get you some light. Yeah, it's better. It's pretty darn simple. One of the utility AC wires pretty much just goes into the ends up into the capacitor. The capacitor to the common on the bridge rectifier. Then you got the other AC line going into the other common on the bridge rectifier. And you got positive, negative. And that just comes out the side over here to where my alligator clamps will be going. Can't get any easier than that. Total parts cost for this project. Capacitor was about $5. And show that again in case anybody is interested in the size I use. Obviously, you can use larger capacitors or smaller. Smaller, such as for a child's little motorized ride-on toy or a motorcycle battery, or larger for electric cars. Or an alternative to going with just one large capacitor is you can connect multiple small ones in parallel in order to increase the overall capacity. If you have two of these, instead of charging at about 2.5 amps, you'd be at 5 amps. You add three, and now it's 5, 6, 7, 7.5 amps. Of course, it's approximate. The bridge rectifier. This is my first time using this specific brand bridge rectifier. I'm going to try charging a dead 12-volt, 125-amp-hour deep cycle battery. And if you have, you got to watch possible heat buildup on the bridge rectifier, and you could possibly shorten its life or burn it out. I recommend, if you got one, this one's a little larger. I'd probably end up cutting it in half, and I can use it on two of these little setups. If you got old laptops, or not laptops, desktop computers, you can use old heatsink from a desktop computer to put underneath your bridge rectifier to help cool it. Cooler bridge rectifier will not only run better, last longer at, I guess the last longer part. So anyways, I paid about $5 plus about $2 shipping for the capacitor. Bridge rectifier was $3.99 at a local electronic surplus store. The multimeter was $2 at Harbor Freight Tools. Wood was free, as I have plenty of it laying around. The most expensive thing on this whole project is the timer. Timer cost about $8.99, if I remember correctly, from Menards Home Improvement Store. About the same thing at Lowe's or Home Depot. So there you have it. If you're having trouble finding these components, you're more than welcome to contact me. I'll sell you the components, or I'd be more than happy to build a complete unit for you for a little extra small fee. And of course, I can tailor them to any size charging you need, or I can even build them into other types of enclosures. Common one we use at our shop for when we build electric car chargers is old ammo cans, military ammo cans. We can also build something to match your electric car if you're having it built for an electric car. We can match paint type, you know, lots of different things. Exact paint colors, you can give us your paint color. But there's not much else to talk about. They're simple and straightforward and to the point. You can't get any simpler than these. So, any questions, feel free to post. I'll do my best to answer them.